Praise the Lord. Good evening, everyone. Lord Jesus Prayer Hall Ministries welcomes you all for this prayer. Hope you all are happy and good. God has given us a precious time to meet again, to gather together and praise Him. Hope you all are watching this channel and praying for us. So now, I request all the church members to sit together in your houses and listen to the Word of God. So now let us start the session with a small prayer. All of you, kneel on and close your eyes. Our most gracious Heavenly Father, thank you, Lord, for giving this day. Thank you for your love. Thank you for your care. Thank you for giving us another day to talk about you. Thank you, Lord, for giving me the chance of standing before you. Thank you, Lord, for blessing me. Thank you giving for this opportunity. Thank you, Lord, for the people who are watching this video. Thank you, Lord, bless me and bless the people who are watching this. In the name of Jesus, amen. Now let's start this prayer, the small song by Joyce and Jessica. There's a land that is fair than day. You all enjoy the song. Thank you, children, for the beautiful render. So now let us thank God for giving us this opportunity. As many of them not having this opportunity, we are having this such an opportunity, and so we should thank God for this opportunity. So you all, I hope you all are praying for me and for our ministry so that it should be continued. So now I had taken the topic, submission to God makes a mature man. Submission to God makes a mature man. So you can refer the scriptures, James 4th chapter 1 to 17 verse. The whole message will be on this verses only. So no need to refer the Bible frequently. You can be with this book of James only. So submission to God makes a mature man. So here the main verse says that submit yourself therefore to God. See, let us see the main verse. from James 4:7. So then, submit to God, resist the devil, and he will run away from you. So, submitting. Submitting means we have to completely submit ourselves to God. Means completely we have to depend on God. So when we completely depend on God, will be our life will be a fruitful life. So God says that submit yourself though to God, therefore to God. So we have to submit ourselves to God, leaving everything to God. Just how we depend on our parents for everything, thinking that, seeking that they are going to do everything for us. We sleep happily by telling all our needs and everything to our parents, right? Yes. So the same way, when we have a lot of faith on our early parents, why don't we have a good faith on God who had created us on the purpose of something? So he is saying that submit yourselves to me. That means we have to submit our life. That means we should be very spiritual and we should submit all our needs and everything, all our life unto him. And we have to move on our life according to his will. That is what submission means. According to his word, we have to move on. We have to lead our life according to his will. That is what submission of our life. So when we submit our life, we'll be very happy. Why? Because our life is led by God now. So if you don't submit yourself to God and live as you like, we don't have a beautiful life. Why? Because we ourselves are leading ourselves. We ourselves are leading our life. So there is a lot of difference between our leading and led by God. So when we are led by God, our path will be straight enough. Our path will be having great light. We can see the way clearly. We can go very happily to the destiny what we are having in our life. But when we lead ourselves by ourselves, our way will not be straight enough. Many sorrows, many troubles, many trials and temptations will be there. So you might ask me, if we submit ourselves, won't we have any trials? Yes, we will be having trials and temptations. Definitely we are going to have. Even God also came across the temptations. But he is able to overcome means he has submitted himself to his Father. He kept all his life into his Father. He gave everything to his Father. So what he is leading, how he is leading, in that way Jesus Christ led his life on this earth. Because he submitted his life to his Father. That is what I am saying now. When we submit ourselves to God, our way will be very clear. So now let us see. We have to do this that we might escape. So we have to do something here to escape from few things. That means when we submit ourselves, I told you that we are going to be very happy. Our life will be spiritual and fruitful. And if we are to do this, that we might escape. So there are few things that we have to take away from us. We have to remove from our lives. The first one is the flesh. The second one is worldly lust. So the first one is the flesh. That means we have to leave all the worldly lust. See, when we see James 4 chapter 1st verse. Where do all the fights and quarrels among you come from? The question in this verse, in the scriptures, it is saying that where do all the fights and quarrels among you come from? They come from your desires for pleasure, which are constantly fighting with you. You want things, but you can't have them. So you are ready to kill. You strongly desire things, but you can't get them. So you quarrel and fight. And you do not have what you want because you do not ask God for it. And when you ask, you do not receive it because your motives are bad. You ask for things to use for your own pleasures. Unfaithful. Don't you be the God's enemy? Whoever wants to be the world's friends makes himself God's enemy. So here it says, the scripture says that when we do friendship with the world, when we think about the flesh, it means the worldly pleasures, what we want, definitely we are going to have so many quarrels. This worldly lust will help make us to quarrel with each other, fight with each other. The scripture says here that they come from your desires for pleasure. When we want something, see, in this, I'll take an example from the school itself. See, the students, what they're doing is they'll be carrying beautiful compass box with them. So the child who is not having that one, he decides to have that pleasure with him also. He wants that box, the compass box. It's very beautiful, very attractive. So now his heart starts desiring for that pleasure, that happiness what the other boy is having there. So they start the fight among them. He tried to steal from him, or he tried to ask him that, can I have this for some time? So this makes them to be have quarrel between them. So not only this, so many things in this world, sometimes you don't have them, others will be having that, and will be thinking that, why don't I have that? So this is what we are struggling with the world. So if we remove all these things from our desires, if we are away from these things, definitely we are going to be happy. So let us see the scriptures here. 1 Corinthians 3rd chapter 3rd verse says that, 1 Corinthians 3rd chapter 3rd verse says that, because of you still live as people of this world live, when there is jealousy among you and you quarrel with one another. Doesn't this prove that you belong to the world, living its by its standing, by standards? So Corinthians says that, Apostle Paul is saying that, by seeing the scripture, we can say that you belongs to world, not belongs to God. Like how it is saying that you belongs to world. See, because you still as the people of the world live, because our nature is not the nature of God. Our nature is like the world's nature, jealousy, having unwanted desires in our heart. So this shows that you're not the child of God, you're the child of this world. And next we'll see, when we come to the life of Samson, when he is born, when he is grown up, he was under the control of God. His life was submitted to God. But when he went in search of these worldly pleasures, he lost all his power. When he met this Delilah, she is a worldly pleasure for him now. So he gave all the secrets to the Delilah. He told why his hair was not shaved. Everything, all the secrets was revealed to her. So as soon as he revealed the secrets to the lady, what happened? All his grace has been all the grace of God had left him and went. So then God struggled there. He struggled for the strength of God. Of course, later he asked God for the forgiveness. And again, he bought the strength of God, grace of God. That means I'm not saying that if you live according to your life, God will not help you. I'm not saying that. But when you completely depend on God, when you completely submit yourself to God, there is chance for God to help us in all ways. So if you are able to go away from this worldly life, definitely you are going to be happy. And next one is the world. The world is the most beautiful and attractive place for us. We can see a colorful situations in our life. It attracts us in such a way that it makes us to forget our Lord Jesus Christ. Once when our heart becomes weak towards the worldly pleasures, obviously what happens here, Satan will help us to move our mind towards the world. It attracts. That's a weak point what we are having in our life. We should not give a chance to Satan. That's why I'm saying that we should submit ourselves to God. When we completely submit ourselves to God, there is no chance for Satan entering into our hearts. So the world is very beautiful, very colorful, very attractive. It attracts us like anything. The world will reveal that we are living in the living world. It shows that in such a way that we are living in the living world. So when we try to live by ourselves, when we don't depend on God, see, some people think that whatever the achievement they achieve in their life, if they had been grown up or if they have achieved something great in their life, they think that they themselves have achieved these things. No. This greatness or these achievements are only because of God Jesus Christ. So when we think that we ourselves had achieved these things, means definitely we are in the worldly life only. That means when we achieve something, there should be a witness that God has given us this. So in this world, we can see that everything will be very clear for us. It makes us to forget the spiritual life what we had led till now. In such a way, the world will make us to separate us from God into the world. So now let us see here in Genesis 19:26. When we see the scriptures, Genesis 19:26. But Lot's wife looked back and was turned into a pillar of salt. So when God want to destroy the Sodom, what happened? Lot's wife is not ready to leave the place and go because the place is a beautiful place, a wonderful place where all the rich people will be there. Where they had led a beautiful life, the worldly life in that place, Sodom. In the Sodom, what happened is they had led a life which is very beautiful life. Maybe they had never, she thought that if I go away from here means I may not have such life. What I have here, if I go anywhere means. That means she loved that place, Sodom. She loved that place than God. She gave place into the heart, to the place, not for the God. That means she loved the place where she led her life, not God. So we can see here the example that if we love the world, not God, means what will happen to us? So let us see here, in this scripture says that Lot's wife had become a pillar of salt. Why? Because she didn't listen to the word of God. Why? Because she don't have the experience of love of God. She had experience of loving the world only, the people in the world, the pleasure what she is having there, the love and everything what she had experienced in that area, in that place. And Sodom is very, very beautiful and attractive place. She don't want to leave it. Even though they decided to go from there, her heart is pulling her back to stay back in Sodom. So Lot, his children, these all people, they had decided themselves to move from there, but his wife is not ready to move there. This is what worldly pleasure. This is what we have to live in our life. So finally what happened? She became a pillar. Why she became a pillar? God said that don't turn back. See, let us see the scriptures here, 26th verse. But Lot's wife looked back and once turned into a pillar of salt. Let us go a little front into the verses. Right. Let us see the 24th verse. Suddenly the Lord rained burning Sodom and Gomorrah and destroyed them and whole valley along with all people there and everything they grew in land. But Lot's wife looked back and turned was into a pillar of salt. He said that don't turn back and go straight away. But this woman, she didn't listen because she don't have relation with God now. She is having relation with the world only. That's why she was turned to pillar. Next, let's third one is the devil. Let us see the verse here. James 4th chapter 6th and 7th verses says like this. But the grace that God gives is even stronger, as scripture says, God resists the proud but gives grace to humble. So then submit to God, resist the devil and he will run away from you. So the scripture says that if we are humble, he will resist us from everything. So God is saying that submit to God, resist the devil and he will run away from you. When you submit yourself to God, instead of submitting yourself to the world, to the people whom you love, to whom you have confidence, instead of all these people, when you turn back towards God and submit yourself, God will help us to overcome this devil. So these three things are very, very dangerous things: the flesh, the world, and the devil. See, we can see in the beginning only, Adam and Eve, when we come to the Garden of Eden, we can see here, Genesis 3:1-7, here we can see, in the beginning only, what happened here? Satan had played a game with Eve. Third chapter, 1-7 verse, we can see here. Snake is also one of the creation of God, but it became so cunning. So now the snake was the most cunning animal that the Lord had made. The Lord God had made the snake. Asked the woman, did God really tell you not to eat fruit from any tree in the garden? So see here, Satan started his cunning nature. He started his duty to change the mind of the people. It want to change the people's mind to the world, to fall into sin. So here let us see, here it is questioning Eve that, did God really tell you not to eat fruit any tree in the garden? Yeah. We may eat the fruit of any tree in the garden, the woman answered. The woman is saying, Eve is saying that, yeah, we can eat any of the fruit in the garden, but the fruit which is in the middle of the... So let us see, X of the tree in the middle of it, God told us not to eat the fruit of the tree or even touch it. If we do, we will die. She is very clear with what God has said. with the words of God. She is very clear with the words of the God. But here we can see the how the Satan is convincing the woman to change her mind. That's what I'm saying. The world is very, very beautiful. It makes us to forget the truth what the God has revealed to us. In such a way, the world will make us to change ourselves. It is a magic world which will change our lives in seconds. So let us see here. It is saying, the snake replied, "That's not true. Who said this? That's not true." So what is true here? According to the snake, God said that because he knows that when you eat it, you'll be like God. See how the Satan is changing the mind of the woman. The snake is saying that if you eat this fruit, means you are going to become like God. So obviously what happened? The mind of the woman had been changed. So her desire towards this being God had been increased in her. Okay, if I can also become a God. She thought that. See, in a situation what happened? Satan had changed this woman because as at that moment as they left God and came out of that situation, now they were in the hands of the Satan. So this is how the devil will trap us, will tempt us. So when we are really in the hands of God, when we submit ourselves to God, God will definitely help us to overcome the devil. So he is saying, so then submit to God, resist the devil, he will run away from you when you submit yourself. If in that situation, that moment, if you had thought about this God's word, what he said, maybe there won't be sin. But Satan did not give any chance to think about it. Of course, it is a. Satan already had planned to destroy the children of God. It is its duty in the beginning of the. In the beginning, in the heaven only, it started its cruel nature of this sin. Right. So here it says that if. See how Eve had been tempted and changed herself in this way. If we don't submit ourselves to God, if we are not in the hands of our Lord Jesus Christ, definitely what will happen? The same thing will happen to us. Of course, we are having this experience of getting tempted with the Satan. So many times we will be falling and getting up and again going to turn towards God. So now let us see, here another option is given to us. We are to do this that we might enjoy. So let us see what we have to do here. What we have to do now? Let us think about this. If we do some, here it says that if you do like this, you'll be enjoy your life. It is saying that. So what we have to do here, let us see the scriptures. James 4:6. But the grace that God gives you is even stronger, as the scripture says, God resists the proud but gives grace to the humble. When you are humble, when we are humble enough, when we will be humble, when we submit ourselves to God, we will be humble to God. Definitely God is there with us. He'll be walking in front of us. He'll helping us to overcome all the situations. So here again we have two types of things which we can enjoy our life if we do with these things. If you take the God's guidance, if you take the God's guidance, that means when we submit ourselves and leave everything to God and say that you are the Lord for me, everything, you are the way for me, nobody is there for me, you are the only one, tell me how to live in this world. If you really submit yourself to God and ask him to, definitely he is going to guide us so that we will not fall into temptations. There will be no quarrels in between our the people in the world. There will be no jealousy. There will be no hatredness among the people. We will be very happy when you have the guidance of the God. And the other one is God's grace. When God's grace is upon you and me, you need not to worry about the Satan's tricks, which is going to play on us. Here, what I want to say is, if we do this, if you submit yourself to the grace of God, if you submit yourself for His guidance, definitely you are going to enjoy our life, means our spiritual life. When we submit ourselves to God, Holy Spirit will be working with us. We'll be living with the Holy Spirit. When we're working with the Holy Spirit, what happens here is our mind will be toward the scriptures of God only. We'll be thinking about the God's word. We'll be thinking about the God's love. We'll be thinking about the God only for everything. We don't have time to think about the world. When you don't have time to think about the world, see here, the first verse says in this James 4th chapter, where do all the fights and quarrels come among you? Where do all the fights and quarrels among you come from? When you are with God, when you submit yourself with God, no need of answering the question here. Why? Because when we are with God, when we are living with God, when we are staying with God, there is no need of fights and quarrels and all these things. We don't need to give any chance to the such situations. Here they come from your desires for pleasure. When you are not with God, when you are with world, you'll have these dreadful desires in your mind, the only pleasures. But when you are loved, when you are with God, when you submit yourself with God, we can see that our life will be totally different. We don't think about the world, worldly pleasures. Our life will be very simple. Our thoughts will be very simple. We'll be very humble. We'll be very kind towards everyone. This is the life what we have in the living God, when we live with the Lord Jesus Christ. Just compare these two things. When we submit ourselves to God, how we are. When we live the God and live in this world, how we are. The one who explains this Holy Spirit, the one who leads the life of God with God, will know this difference. The one who walk with God will be always thinking to talk to God, doing good to others. That life will be totally different. The experience will be totally different. That experience will be very tremendous one in our life. So we need to experience a life that which leads to God's love. So my dear believers, those who are watching this, I just request you all to submit yourselves to God, so that we don't see nowadays what we are doing in this corona situation, what we are doing. We are just scared about this situation. Why we are scared of the situation? Because we are not submitting ourselves to God. If you submit yourselves to God, definitely we don't worry about this virus. So, my dear believers, don't think that we are staying home and unable to go somewhere, going out and do something. Now, this is the time for us to live with God. God has given a precious time. Submit yourself to God and pray to Him and live a beautiful life which God wants to be in. My dear Lord Jesus Prayer Hall Ministry, my dear members of this Lord Jesus Prayer Hall Ministries, let us all together submit ourselves to God and see the change in our life, how the life will be when we submit our life to God. Let us be a children of God now. Let us welcome our lives. Let us give all our burdens to God and live with Him. And we'll just give the key to God and ask Him to play our life. We'll see the change. So my dear believers, those who are watching this video, please submit yourself to God. If you had not submitted yourself to God till now, this is the time for you to submit your life to God and lead a happy life. Enjoy your life under the guidance of His, under the guidance of God, under the grace of God and His goodness. our life will be very beautiful, very beautiful, very attractive. So my dear believers, those who are watching this one, remember these words. Go to the scriptures once, James 4:1-17. Here, 1 Peter 5:5 says that about the grace. I want to tell you again about the grace. 1 Peter 1:5. Because in the same way, you young man must submit to the older man, and all of you must put on the apron of humility to serve one another, for the scripture says God resists the proud but shows favor to the humble. So here's a call for us that we have to be humble and submit ourselves to the older man, means to the God. We have to submit ourselves, and then we'll be very happy. The last one is under the guidance of God. James 4:13-15, let us see these two verses and we'll close the session. Now listen to me, you that say, today or tomorrow, we will travel to a certain city where we'll stay a year and go into business and make a lot of money. You don't even know that your life tomorrow will be. You are like a puff of smoke, which appears for a moment and then disappears. What you should say is this: if Lord is willing, we'll live and do this for that. Do this or that. But now you are proud and you boast. All your boasting is wrong. So the scripture is saying that we don't know how our life will be. It's like a puff of smoke. So don't know how the life will be. We don't know when you're going to end your life. So the scripture says that we have to submit ourselves to God. We have to submit ourselves to His willing. We have to submit ourselves to His willing only. If He is willing to do that, He'll do that for us. What is good for us, He's going to do that. So my dear believers, my dear brothers and sisters, remember this, that in the scriptures once again, James 4:1-17, it gives us a wonderful life to us. It leads us a wonderful life. It gives us a way to a wonderful life with God. So when you give a chance to His grace, when you give a chance to His guidance, when you give a chance to His goodness, definitely we're going to enjoy our life. So let us close the session with a small prayer. Our most gracious Heavenly Father, thank you, Lord, for giving us this opportunity. So, Lord, help us to wait for your will. Help us to submit ourselves and live according to your will. Why? Because our life is like puff of smoke. We don't know when we are going to end our life. Lord Jesus, help us. If we are still in these worldly pleasures, help us to turn towards you and take your guidance, take your grace, take your goodness and live according to your will. In the name of Jesus, amen. My dear brothers and sisters, thank you for watching this video. Please pray for us, for the Lord Jesus Ministries, so that it will be continued with a graceful and spiritual lead in this world. Thank you for everything. Thank you for watching this. Please pray for the ministries, especially, and those who are watching, be blessed with the message what we are being passing on to you. So be blessed with the message. And if you are still in the worldly life, please submit yourselves and ask God. He is going to help you. Thank you in the name of Jesus. Amen.